This video will demo the structure of an output file for a single point energy computation inside of Psi4. Okay, so as before, I have Psi4 in my path ready to go. I have my Psi scratch variable set inside my bash rc file. Set that inside your TCSHRC or other file if you're using some other shell. So that's all ready to go. I have this input file here called demo2.in. And inside this input file, I have a water dimer hartree-fock aug ccpvqz calculation setup. So I have this comment line telling me those facts that I just said. I have the molecule section where I've declared Cartesian coordinates for two water molecules, OHH, OHH, X, Y, and Z coordinates in these columns respectively. One of the nice things about Psi4 is I can do these things where I declare multiple kind of submolecules inside of my molecule. So if I have the water dimer, it overall is a neutral singlet. Both waters are electrically neutral and all the electrons are paired. So I could have something like this, where I have just all six atoms in my molecule declared inside of one neutral singlet there. But I could also do this, where I have both of them declared as neutral singlets. Psi4 will recognize both of those styles of input. Okay, I'm going to give that 2,000 megabytes or 2 gigabytes of memory. Set the basis set to augmented correlation consistent polarized valence quadruple zeta, the Dunning basis set. And I'm going to call energy hartree-fock. Okay, so I'm going to run Psi4 on this input file. I'm going to say Psi4 demo2.in, and why don't I say -n2, and I'll run it with two threads using two cores. Okay, so it's doing my SCF iterations now, and we have already completed. So 6 seconds for that job, very short job as well. We see that Psi4 exiting successfully lets us know that the output is complete and there were no errors on the way. Okay, so now in this video we want to step through what are the parts of the output file for this energy computation inside of Psi4. So inside this demo2.out, what I have at first at the top is printing out a header detailing Psi4, what version of the code it is, authors, etc., what time it was, process ID, those sorts of things. And it's going to repeat the input file, letting me know what input file I'm running in this particular output file. Set the memory, then the SCF program starts. As before we saw, it's running on two threads. It shows me the geometry of the molecule, so it figured out I had those two water molecules. There's the X, Y, and Z coordinates of all of those. Okay, things about number of electrons, how many are spin up and spin down. We know that because of the multiplicity being 1. Okay, it's going to say how many basis functions there are. There are 344 basis functions in 96 shells in this basis set. Max angular momentum, L equals 4, so that would be up to S, P, D, F, G functions. Okay, some information about the algorithm, what it's doing. Now we have our SCF iterations. So for RHF, we have to do a self-consistent field. We have to take our guess orbitals and then converge the energy down to a self-consistent converged energy. So we're starting there at the first iteration, and we see the energy drops lower and lower until we eventually converge down to this -152.13 hartrees. We can see in the final step there, we converge down to 4 × 10⁻⁷ in terms of the change between iterations in the energy, and similarly very small changes on the in the density matrix over here. Okay, so after the SCF is complete, we have information about what the energies of all the orbitals are. We see the 1s orbitals on each of the oxygens at -20, very low energy. Then all the valence orbitals from 3 to 10, all these doubly occupied orbitals for those 20 electrons. Then we're going to have a whole bunch of virtual orbitals all the way up to the number of basis functions. As I said, in this case, that was 344, or whatever that came out to be. Okay, with the final RHF energy, some information about the components of that in terms of one electron, two electron, and nuclear repulsion energy. Then we have some properties, the nuclear and electronic components of the dipole moment, and then the total molecular dipole moment, X, Y, and Z, and total in atomic units and in Debye. Then information about how long this computation took. This particular module, the SCF module, took 6 seconds, or 0.1 minutes, and it was the only module to run, so the total time in this case ends up being 6 seconds. And then, as we see, our flag at the end letting us know that Psi4 has completed successfully. So that is the basic structure of the output file for an energy computation in Psi4.